Hi everyone, I'm Giovanni Laquidara from the Developer Relations team, and I'm delighted to introduce you to the Amazon Input SDK. The Amazon Input SDK enhances the user experience by providing display on screen information for the available inputs for specific action in games. For example, if you have an existing Android app and would like to add support for the Amazon App Store or Windows, you need to add more input controls beyond touch, such as keyboard, mouse, stylus, or gamepad, to optimize the gameplay for PCs. Each control in your game needs to map to distinct action, and building on-screen menus can be time-consuming. You can save time and developer effort by following along as I show you how to get started with the Input SDK. Let's get started. The Input SDK enhances the user experience by providing display on-screen information for the available inputs for specific action in games, as is shown here. The Input SDK dialog displays the input action mappings in a clear way. An input action refers to an event that corresponds to an action performed within the app. This action can be associated with a single key or a combination of keys. Each input action must be linked to a specific input group. Each input group consists of a label and a collection of input actions categorized within a group. We will see how to create input actions and input groups, and how to customize the Input SDK dialog in the code walkthrough. Whether you prefer native Android development or building with Unity, we have you covered. The Amazon Input SDK comes in two versions: Amazon Input SDK for Java and Kotlin, and Amazon Input SDK for Unity. Let's start by exploring the usage of the Amazon Input SDK for Java and Kotlin. To begin using the SDK in your app, add the Amazon Input SDK to the dependency section of your app-level build Gradle file. You can choose to download the SDK from Maven, or you can download the Input SDK IAR from the Amazon App Store website and include it into your libs folder, adding the following dependency line. The main component of this SDK is the input mapping provider. When a user requests an help screen, the SDK will use this provider to present the control action map. The first step in using the input mapping provider is to implement the input mapping provider interface and return your input map in the onProvideInputMap method. You need to create your input actions. An input action refers to an event that corresponds to an action performed within the app. Each input action is associated to a key or a combination of keys. And each input action must be linked to a specific input group. Each input group consists of a label and a collection of input actions categorized within a group. After defining all the necessary groups, you can pass them to the inputMap.create method to return the input map for your app. Once you have implemented the input mapping provider interface, you can register your input mapping provider through the InputStatic class. The active input mapping provider is not affected by the activity lifecycle events and remains valid across different activities. However, you can change it whenever you prefer by using the input mapping client and setting a different input mapping provider. After defining the input mapping provider, you can simply call the showHelp method to display the help screen to guide the user on how to play your game. And if we build and run this project, we can see our help dialog screen created by the Amazon Input SDK. Now let's see the steps here for integrating the Amazon Input SDK into your project if you are using Unity to build your game. Download the Amazon Input SDK for Unity. The download includes the Unity package file and a sample app. From the Asset menu, select Import Package, Custom Package. Browse for the Amazon Device Input Mapping Unity package and select it. Select all the files in the subsequent import dialog and click Import. Go to Preferences, External Tools, and in the Android section, uncheck Gradle Install with Unity and choose the required Gradle version for your project. We recommend version 5.6.4. Go to Project Settings, Player, and select the Android tab. Expand the Publishing Settings section. And in the Build section, click the checkbox for Custom Launcher Gradle Template, as shown in the video. Then open the Launcher Template file for Gradle and add the following couple of dependencies. Implement the Input Mapping Provider interface from the Amazon Input SDK for Unity, and the SDK will be able to show the input mapping when a user requests an help screen. The input map return from the onProvideInputMap method will contain all the mapping key events mouse click to the input actions. An input action is an event corresponding to an app action, and an input action can be mapped to a key or a combination of keys. Remember to group all the input action related inside an input group. Each input group has a group label and a list of input action that belongs to that group. Then you can collect all your groups of input and pass it to the input map creation. To use your custom input mapping provider, you need to register it by calling set input mapping provider of the input mapping client, as shown in the video. After registering, you will be able to show the help screen with the mapping to the user, calling the trigger handle showHelp. Let's build a run to see the help dialog. By integrating the Amazon Input SDK, you can provide clear instruction to player on how to use keyboard and mouse inputs effectively. This will help ensure a smooth transition from touch controls to pitch inputs and enhance the overall user experience. Make sure to read our developer docs to learn more about integrating the Input SDK into your Android apps and games. Thank you!